after the sunrise, and Bruce looking at some rain on radar.
Hi, this is Bruce Hubbard. Welcome to your Fox 8 News weather forecast. So tell you, today in the sky you will see raindrops, but sometimes you will not see it. Welcome to Mid-City.
When guests to New Orleans are staying in a home share, they generally stay for longer, which enables them to feel like a part of the city. My name is Nancy, and I'm an Airbnb host in the...
We are not like the rest of the United States. We are Spanish West Florida. Our influences do not come from a background of Protestant religion, Puritanical roots, and British law. It's not us. We come from civil law.
You have all new residents, people from out of town that don't know our culture. You see them, hey, good morning, how are you? They're shocked that we say good morning. Where they probably come from, they don't have some people that interact with them.
You know, be a homeowner, or at least rent it to, we have a lot of elderly that would love to be in a neighborhood, back in a neighborhood where there's a community, but they can't afford it.
Siento como negocio, yo siento que yo miro muchos gente que vienen de diferentes partes del país, diferentes partes del mundo que vienen y se quedan en un Airbnb aquí cerca y ayuda pues, los ayuda a nosotros.
The thing that instills the community are the people in it. The people who grew up around here, the people who see it every day, the people who are passing it on through word of mouth, those of us who are passing it on in song, those of us who are putting back and redeveloping into our neighborhoods and building up those old buildings and opening those doors back up where our kids could go and run freely. It's us. We are the difference. We are what are going to make or break our neighborhoods here in New Orleans.
To think about the street flood. Yeah, I'm gonna sweep this section. Okay, what's that? Hey, I see that you're doing this. Could you use this tool? I don't use it anymore. There is a real, in here especially, real neighborliness, and it stretches. It's not, I could walk one block, two blocks, three blocks over, one block down, a couple of blocks up, knock on somebody's door and say, hey, blah, blah, do you, could you? And they go, yeah, sure, yeah.
I'd be friends with the whole block, because it's a good thing.
I think we've overdone it, catering to tourists. You know, we have a really high proliferation of Airbnb, which is really making it hard for anyone of any income to live in New Orleans. And I think that's going to be a problem because we don't create new jobs in New Orleans. We haven't really created any new jobs. But we do need affordable housing for the folks who live here. And I think that's crucial to the future of this city. Really.
Thousands of jobs are headed to the metro area over the next 2 years, according to the Louisiana Economic Outlook released on Wednesday.
Economists at LSU say the two new hospitals in Mid-City and proposed developments in the city will lead to more than 17,000.
Do you think there's a lot of jobs in the neighborhood?
No.
No. It's not really that many job opportunities.
Many jobs is hotels.
Yeah. And they actually dropped the pay in hotels because I actually worked in hospitality. And the pay is actually going down instead of up, which is really weird.
Summer's here. Are you looking for a change of scenery? Find your next job at NewOrleansJobsList.com.
More choices up and down the aisles. You're saving money.
Thank you for shopping at Swagman.
Swagman style.
In the neighborhood, actually, Swagman's would be down the street. And now it's a Whole Food, but it's not like a full grocery store like we used to have. We have Rouse's behind us, okay, and you have Winn-Dixie, but we had more stores where you could really shop and bargain shop.
I'm able to travel probably 10 minutes away, 5-10 minutes away to get my thing, so I don't have to go 30 minutes away or 15-20 minutes, right. You know, so that is a good thing. Of course we need some farms around here,
right.
You know, or some gardens.
Too, you know,
like. Yeah.
Staggering new numbers.
members from the Orleans Parish DA's office, 735 new juvenile felony cases in 2018, almost as many in 2016 and 2017 combined. The million-dollar question is why?
And that's due to not having a community that we once had. People can come walk on the sidewalk, come talk to people, come engage, you know. You never judge a book by its cover. We quickly to do that. People always quick to talk about what another kid is going through, but unless you live in that kid's house, if you come swap out houses, then you understand what's going on, you know. But when you're fending for yourself, you're a 13-year-old kid, or you know, your grandmother's no longer living, you have to look after your sister, you have to make ends meet at this age, then the only thing you know to do is crime. And it's sad, but that's what it is, because nobody's teaching them, you know. So until you help, don't judge, you know, pretty much.
The New Orleans Recreation Department is a public service, but the public doesn't seem to be too happy with how it's run or how its parks and playgrounds are maintained and utilized.
I'm not going to say you don't have the right people running it, but the motivation is different for getting kids to come out and join a baseball team or join a, you know, the swim team, which a lot of the individual parks, like I've mentioned, don't have their own pools anymore. But basketball courts, you don't have people running them year round like it used to be. Unfortunately, we have a lot of youth that rather choose the other side, the robbery, the drugs, and you have to find a way to reel them in and try and bring it back. That's hard.
Just over the last week or two, we've identified juveniles becoming more brazen in these particular crimes. And as such, we would like to make sure our citizens know that we are aware and we're staying the course. We've arrested several juveniles over the last few weeks.
If I had power, I would lighten up the whole world and make people be nice to each other, not be bad. Yeah. I wish God was just still living. Because you know he's watching everything. I'm excited about fifth grade because it's like it's good. I don't know how it would be to be in fifth grade. I'm done with this stuff. I don't even know what to say. I don't know what to say no more.
Born in New Orleans, raised in New Orleans. I will forever remain faithful, New Orleans. I thank you, New Orleans. Thank you, Holly Grove. Has been my hood since the snotty nose. I come through the hood, suicidal doors. I used to come through.